So I've gone ahead and put together a little bit of a website. It may not look like much because it was made with Legos, but it's actually following the same principles that we're learning in this class. This green piece in the background represents the browser window. We can see that the browser here is actually a little bit wider than the page. Remember, a lot of websites like to center themselves in the page, so they have content that fits a certain amount of space, and if your browser is wider than that, well, there's just a little bit of space left over, and that's okay. But we have a lot of options for the way we want to lay out our content. It can be in just one long, big column like this that takes up the entire width, or it could be two half columns, you know, 50-50, or why not break it into thirds like we have here, or even smaller pieces. In this case, it's broken into six. We could do a very popular design where we have one narrow column and then one wide column, or we could just do some kind of other crazy design that doesn't really follow any of these patterns. The point being is that what we want to do is build a grid system that gives us the flexibility to make any of the column designs that you see here. Let's start thinking about how to implement responsive design using CSS. In order for a website to resize based on the size of the browser, we're not going to be able to use a fixed pixel size to determine the width of columns. Instead, we'll have to use percentages to decide how wide our columns should be. Once again, we're back on the Reddit homepage, and let's see if we can make this column on the right responsive instead of keeping it at a fixed width. I'm going to go ahead and right-click on it anywhere in here and hit Inspect Element to pull up the console. Aha, and we can see that the element of the class side is this sidebar. We can see it highlighted right here. Let's see if we can change its width. I'll come over here and scroll down. We find a CSS property called width, and currently it's set to 300 pixels. Remember, you can change websites using DevTools, so let's go ahead and change this one right now. I'll double click, and instead of 300 pixels, I'm gonna set it to 24%. And the reason I'm doing 24% is 300 pixels is actually 24% of this screen's resolution that you're looking at. So 24% keeps this column at the same size. I'll press enter, and it looks the same. Let me get rid of DevTools. So now I'm going to resize the screen, but this column on the right is actually going to resize responsively instead of staying at a fixed width. This time when we made the screen smaller, we see that this column got smaller as well. It didn't stay at the same size because we used a percentage to define its width. It's pretty common to see websites with grid systems that allow for either 2, 3, or 4 columns, as well as websites that use one narrow column and then one wide column, which in this case would take up the other three. The Udacity homepage, for example, uses 4 columns to highlight our featured courses. If you go to our course catalog, you'll notice that we have one narrow column and then one wide column. This one takes up about a quarter of the screen, while this guy takes up the other 3/4. On the Coursera homepage, you'll see an example of 3 columns. They've got their courses laid out in 3 even columns. Which of the following grid sizes is going to allow for just enough customization? Meaning that we'll be able to get those common 2, 3, 4 column wide screens and have enough flexibility to do them however we want without adding overhead of columns that we're never going to use. Do you think 5 columns is enough? 8 columns? 12 columns? Or do you think that we need 20 columns to get the customization we need?